This is a brand new experience for me. I have never been shoe shopping in the snow before. I'm here with Mike Taylor from 5028 as part of the Minturn Winter Market. You had quite the trek getting over here this morning, huh?
Yeah, it's definitely the winter market. I came from Carbondale and forgot the top of my tent, so I had to do a quick turnaround on I-70 and get here a little bit late, but nothing too bad.
Hey, you made it. Everybody's getting set up. You're getting ready for this market. And Mike, you have the coolest company. You and your wife started this shoe company, but it's not just any shoe company. Can you just tell us a little bit about your story?
Yeah, so my wife's been a footwear designer for 15 years for some bigger companies. To name a few, she worked for Deckers, which does Simple and Uggs, and then she worked for Oakley, North Face, and Taos footwear. And she'd always go over to Spain and Portugal and come back with these amazing shoes that no one could get. So she kind of came with the idea, well, maybe we could, you know, bring over small batches of the shoes and get them to the American customers. So we make as little as, we've gone as low as 15 pairs per run, and the most we made is 70 of one shoe. We donate $5 back to mental health awareness. My wife's on the board at Aspen Strong over in Aspen. And yeah, we do very small batches. And this shoe is actually made from our dead stock program. It's called the Walrus. It's one of our newer ones. And what that is, Angelina went over to Portugal 2 or 3 months ago, and they just have a bunch of leather in the basement. And it's basically going to go into landfill or just kind of go to waste and wither away. So she went down and sifted through all the dead stock material. They said, okay, we can make 15 pairs of shoes with this amount, 15 with this, 15 with that. So they pieced together a bunch of shoes. So our newest line all comes from the dead stock material. It just saves on waste. The footbed's made from all recycled shoe material as well. So we're just trying to kind of cut back on waste. We don't do shoe boxes. We do shoe bags and just try to be a little more environmental friendly in the shoe business. So
I mean, this is incredible. So you're a homegrown business. You're based out of Carbondale. So you're basically our neighbors. And then you're not only, you know, using some of the material that would have gone to the landfill to make these shoes, but like you said, you don't use bags and boxes for the shoes. Yep. So just on the delivery, you're cutting down on waste there. But then also, let's talk a little bit more about why the small batches are also so environmentally friendly and how that works.
Yeah, because when Angelina's working for some of the big companies, I mean, a lot of the shoes would just end up in a landfill. You know, they'd get thousands made and maybe hundreds would go on the shelves. And some of them they get made and they didn't come out the way they wanted it to. So they would just get basically tossed, and she would just see piles and piles of shoes just get tossed out. So that's where she kind of came up with the idea of very small batches. When we're gone with that batch, we may revisit it down the road, but it'll be gone, not for good, but for the time being. So we kind of, you know, want people to clamor for the shoe and really want to get it while they're getting it good.
Right, and they're not outrageously priced, so they are actually attainable. And this is something where, you know, people can come and they can see you today. They can try on some shoes, figure out the right size. And then you actually have the availability to order shoes online before the batch is even made, right?
Correct. Yeah, we do a pre-order model as well. So we'll put out the picture of the shoe and what shoe's coming. If you pre-order it before it actually shows up to our door, it's about $20 to $30 less than when we actually get the shoe. So kind of give a little bit of customer involvement in the shoe placement as well.
Right. And let's talk about the name 5028. What is that a nod to? So
a lot of people do in Colorado get a little bit confused with 5280 down in the Front Range. Yeah. But Angelina, it's her grandparents' address, and she grew up in Santa Barbara, California, and they've been running a family business out of their home since 1918, a hardwood flooring business. So this is the third generation they're doing it. And her grandparents played a huge role in raising her. Her grandfather passed away a little while ago, but her grandmother's still around. And it's just kind of a tribute to the address and where she grew up.
So sweet. So we are 5028.com, right? That's where people can find you online.
We are 5028.com. You can see all the new releases, our shoes that we have in stock, and just kind of hear the story of how we became a company.
Or you can stop by and see Mike here in person today at the Minturn Winter Market. And you can see all of their gorgeous shoes and the ones that they made from the dead stock. That is fascinating. And how long are you going to be here today, Mike?
I think we're here from 10 to 2, and then we'll be back here in a couple of weeks as well for the next one.
All right, so great. Stop on by, do some shoe shopping.
Some shoes.
I mean...